Grauman, director of operations for Grauman's Chinese Theater. One of the original Hollywood mavericks, Kirk Douglas, ignored his agent's advice to star with Ava Gardner and Gregory Peck in The Great Sinner to take on the role of the anti-hero boxer Midge Kelly at a lesser salary in a lower budget film called Champion. It earned him his first Oscar nomination and made him a star. His second nomination came in 1952 for The Bad and the Beautiful, and the third in 1956 for Lust for Life, playing Vincent Van Gogh. The Motion Picture Academy gave him an Oscar for Lifetime Achievement in 1996. Kirk Douglas formed one of Hollywood's independent film companies, Bryna, in 1955. This is one of the first independent film companies. It is in his mother's name and is managed by his wife, Anne. It gave him the freedom to develop small films of limited mass appeal, like Stanley Kubrick's Paths of Glory and Lonely Are the Brave, his personal favorite of all his films, as well as big-budget epics like The Vikings and, of course, Spartacus. Kirk Douglas actually put his career on the line with Spartacus. The budget started at $4 million and escalated to $12 million by the end of a shoot plagued by illnesses, accidents, and threats of boycott for Douglas' decision to openly credit his blacklisted writer, Dalton Trumbo. Kirk Douglas passed along his famous chin dimple to his son, Michael. But Michael only put his hands and footprints here. Kirk pressed his chin into the cement as well, which you'll see when we unveil the tablet in a few moments. To this day, Kirk Douglas and his son Michael Douglas are actually the only father and son in the forecourt. Kirk and his wife recently celebrated their 58th wedding anniversary. We want to thank all of you for coming today for this momentous occasion. And now I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Kirk Douglas himself. Yay!
Special for me, doing swell. That's a day today that they release a book that I have been working on for years. I Am Spartacus.
Yeah!
And you know, it's hard to write about something that happened 50 years ago. You forget so much. But it's surprising how much you remember. So I'm glad that they're showing Spartacus as a Grauman Chinese theater in an uncut version. You know, I have loved movies since I was a little kid. And when I was a little kid, there were silent movies, and you have to pay 10 cents. And suddenly, everything changed. Talkies, the movie talkies. And the first week in my town, when a talking picture came in, I rushed with my 10 cents. And in the lobby, I found out they raised the prices to 25 cents. And I didn't have the money. So I sat there with my 10 cents. And suddenly I got an idea. There was a woman, an intellectually woman, going to get buy her ticket. So I went up the ramp to a ticket collector, and he said, "Where's the ticket?" And I said, "My mother is buying it out now." And I sucked in, and then I went to the balcony. So that's how I saw my first talking picture. And happened with the letters to be a part of movies. I'm delighted that my son Michael is a part of it. And I'm very happy that today Grauman Chinese Theater, which celebrates 85 years, is showing Spartacus. And it's certainly not a dime, but a quarter. So if you have a quarter, you can see the picture. And if you don't have a quarter, I'll have a... Okay.
Wow. What a souvenir.
Oh. Thank you very much.